Bad breath is also known as halitosis or foetor odorous. Bad breath is one of the well-known reasons for social, emotional and psychological anxieties and reduced confidence. In this video, we're going to see what are the causes for bad breath, how to prevent it and what are the treatment options are there. Almost 90% of bad breath has their origin in oral cavity and the remaining 10% are due to systemic or extraoral cause. Bad breath can be temporary problem or a chronic condition. Halitosis are classified into genuine halitosis, pseudohalitosis and halitophobia. Genuine halitosis are further classified into physiological halitosis and pathological halitosis. Let's see one by one. Physiological halitosis caused due to food containing lactose like milk, cheese, yogurt and ice cream and also food containing sulfur like onion and garlic. Other factors like smoking, alcoholic drinks and lack of salivary flow during sleep. Causes for pathological halitosis. Dry mouth due to decrease in salivary flow, this because of salivary gland dysfunction. Poor oral hygiene, periodontal disease, biofilm coated tongue, pericoronitis, necrotizing ulcerative gingivitis. Bad breath also can be a problem if you wear denture and don't clean them every night. Extraoral causes for pathogenic halitosis are mouth breathing due to upper respiratory tract blockage, pulmonary tuberculosis, chronic sinusitis, chronic bronchitis, lung and gastric carcinoma, infection in upper and lower respiratory tract, tonsil stone, hiatus hernia, pyloric stenosis. Gastroesophageal reflux disorder, zinc deficiency and functional disorder like depression may also become reason for bad breath. Some medication also cause bad breath like oral antihypertensive drugs, lithium salt, dimethyl sulfoxide, etc. Unusual breath odor can be the symptom of some disease. This include liver failure, cause mousy odor, kidney failure, fishy odor, diabetic ketoacidosis, fruity odor, Sjögren syndrome, fetid odor. Let's see the treatment option for bad breath. If bad breath is due to a plaque buildup, a dental cleaning may solve the problem. A deep dental cleaning may be necessary if you have periodontal disease. Treating underlying medical problems can also help improve breath odor, control your blood sugar level. Artificial saliva may prescribe if patient have dry mouth. Use chlorhexidine mouthwash, baking soda containing toothpaste and zinc salt solution reduce bad breath. Prevention of bad breath. Clean your tongue daily by using toothbrush or tongue scraper which helps in remove biofilm over the tongue. Rinse your mouth after taking food. Brush twice daily. Clean between your teeth by using dental floss or interdental brushes. Replace your old toothbrush with a new one every 3 months. If you wear denture, mouth guard and retainer, don't forget to clean it every day. If you smoke, quitting can also help to keep your mouth moist and free of odor. Staying hydrated can often help to eliminate or prevent bad breath. There are some home remedies to reduce bad breath or drink plenty of water, eat fresh fruit like pineapple, orange, apples, eat fibrous vegetable, green tea which has disinfectant and deodorizing property that can temporarily freshen the breath. Let's see about pseudohalitosis and halitophobia. Pseudohalitosis is a condition in which the patient believes that he or she is suffering from bad breath in absence of any objective offensive odor. Halitophobia. After treatment of halitosis, the patient persists in believing that he or she has bad breath. For these patients, counseling is necessary because their problem is psychological.